give him a copy of that arrest affidavit we have given to Mr. West for your behalf. You certainly have a right to counsel. Mr. West is here for you for that purpose. You have a right to contact family or friends about any bond issues in the future, which I'm sure you get contact with those folks as well. I'm here to determine probable cause for your arrest as well as the release conditions, if any, and your next court date. So you are here having been charged with the crime of aggravated assault with domestic violence with a weapon. I have discussed your case a bit in chambers with the attorneys. And before I go ahead and advise you of anything other than your court dates, I'm going to let them discuss matters with me. But I have found probable cause for your arrest based upon this warrant information contained in the court file at this time. You have an arraignment before Judge McIntosh. That'll be, if you're here, it'll be in the jail courtroom next door. If you're out of jail, it'll be on February 17th, 2015 at 1:30 p.m. in court 1A in the Criminal Justice Center. All right. And Mr. Farmer?
Thanks, Keith, request that the defendant no contact with the victim was in the arrest report, and we ask that the defendant be placed in the GPS impact monitor, that he have no return to the incident address, and no return to the victim's address listed in Volusia County. We also ask that the defendant not be allowed to possess any weapons, and to not possess or consume any alcohol on pretrial release.
Would ask for a case level bond. Sure. Your Honor, we certainly agree at this point in time it makes sense to have a no contact provision until this gets sorted out. And we don't oppose any geographical limitations in that regard. We think that the GPS is unnecessary in these circumstances, among other things, including the circumstances of the alleged offense, and that Mr. Zimmerman has a well-established history of appearing as requested in court. We think a reasonable bail is appropriate under these circumstances, and to leave the remaining conditions of discretion.
All right, thank you. Mr. Zimmerman, your case level bond is $5,000. I'm going to leave it at that case level at this time. There will be no contact with the victim who's named in the arrest affidavit through the course of these proceedings unless otherwise allowed for by the judge who's handling this case, which will be Judge McIntosh. I want to order that you not enter Volusia County at any time during the course of these proceedings unless otherwise authorized to do so by that court order by the by Judge McIntosh. Even though there was no firearm alleged to have been used in this offense, I think in abundance of caution, it would be best to go ahead and order you to surrender any firearms that you may have in your possession. I've advised Mr. West that you'll have until Tuesday to do that. I want an affidavit filed with the court with regard to that matter, and they'll take care of that with you. As I said, your bond will remain at $5,000. And as far as the GPS monitor, Mr. Farmer, it appears that the address where this occurred was an address that Mr. Zimmerman was residing at the time, and that the alleged victim has indicated that she does not reside in this county, and by way of her affidavit, so it would make no sense to me to go ahead and order him to not be around that residence or to wear the GPS monitor, as I've restricted movements from the county of her residence by Mr. Zimmerman. So that means, assuming you step over the river and you got a problem, you stay with the rest of Florida, then we won't have a problem.
Yes, sir.
The only other issues that I'm concerned about is that if this person has any personal property at that residence, I couldn't tell, quite frankly, from the arrest affidavit whether there was anything or wasn't anything there remaining, that I'm going to go ahead and order that if there is anything that you're aware of or that's been requested through the state attorney's office that are items of personal property that belong to this person, that you're ordered to go ahead and box those up and give them to your lawyer so that he can make sure that she gets those personal properties back expeditiously. That's fine.
Yes,
I'll avoid any contact issues. Mr. Farmer, is there anything else?
Judge, for the court position on no possession or consumption of alcohol on release.
There wasn't any allegation of use or of alcohol in the arrest affidavit, as far as I can tell, other than an instrument that was alleged to have been used or thrown. So I don't have any basis for doing that. If there had been allegations that this involved the consumption of alcohol, that would have been a provision, but I don't have anything that says that. Anything else, Mr. West?
No, nothing further. Right. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Zimmerman, we'll give you a copy of your paperwork, and you can arrange for bond if you can. Otherwise, we'll see you here in the courthouse at the jail, courtroom, sorry, on the 17th.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.